Hey everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I'm excited to be partnering with Hot Tools. The very first hair tool I ever bought for myself was way back in high school, and it was a Hot Tools flat iron. So I have literally been using their products for years. So I'm really excited about today's video. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you're new, and let's get started. Hot Tools has been my go-to hair tools brand for years, and they just launched the Golden Roast Collection. These are probably the prettiest hair tools I think I've ever used. So with my hair freshly washed, I'm going to start by using the Hot Tools Black Rose Ionic Salon Dryer to dry my hair. This dryer is one of the most powerful dryers you can buy, and it dries my hair so quickly. My favorite feature, however, is all of the settings that it offers. Not only does it have a low and high speed setting, but it also has three heat settings, low, medium, and high. So I like to use the settings that work best for my hair type and texture. Once my hair is all dry, I'm going to use the Golden Rose 1¼-inch Flipperless Curling Wand to curl my hair. The 1¼-inch barrel is my favorite size, and this has a really cool feature as well to adjust the temperature. It has this little knob on the side, and you just push it in and then rotate it to the right or left to raise or lower the temperature. I really love this because then I don't accidentally raise or lower the heat while I'm using it, which is something that has happened with a lot of other hot tools that I've used. So to curl my hair, I always just take 1-inch sections and curl the section away from my face. And this curling wand curled my hair so quickly, I couldn't even believe it. I like to use it at 360 degrees, but it does heat up to 450 degrees, so it works on every hair length, type, and texture. Moving on to the hairstyle, I'm going to start by taking a section of hair on the right side above my ear, divide it into two smaller pieces and twist them together, then wrap it around the back of my head and pin it in place with a few bobby pins. Now I'm going to take a similar section on the left side, divide it into two smaller pieces and twist them together, bringing it around the back of my head, and then I'm just going to pin it underneath the first twist with a few more bobby pins. Now I'm going to go back over the twists and pull on the edges just to make them a little bit fuller. Then I'm going to take a section of hair underneath the center of the twist, place my right forefinger underneath the hair, wrapping the hair around my finger, twist my hand towards the right, and then I'm going to place my thumb through the gap in the hair at the top of the twist, pull the ends through the gap to create a little knot, and then I'm just going to pin the knot against my head with bobby pins.
Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed today's video. If you want to see more how-to videos like this one, make sure to click the thumbs up and be sure to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on any future videos. And I will see you next time.